Hello friends, my name is P.B. Prajapati. I am lecturer in Applied Mechanics Department. I am working in the Government Polytechnic and I am teaching this subject since long. Our topic is coplanar concurrent forces. Previously we see what is force, what are its elements, what are its effect. We also see transmissibility of force, then superposition of force and different force system. As you know, coplanar means forces, coplanar forces means forces lying in a same plane, and concurrent, once again I am repeating, concurrent forces are those forces whose line of action meeting at a common point. Forces are known as concurrent forces. In this topic, our next subtopic is resolution and composition of forces. As you see, resolution is nothing but the way of representing a single force into number of forces without changing the effect of the force on the body or particle is called resolution of force, and this is being done, as I discussed earlier, when mutually perpendicular resolution is being done on two mutually perpendicular axes, as well as resolution can be done on non-perpendicular axis, and components on two perpendicular axis are called as resolved components or even force components. While if we find out on non-perpendicular axis, then they are called as simply components and not the resolved components. Now, resolution of a force into two mutually perpendicular components, when resolution of a force is done on two axes at right angles to each other, then each force is called as resolved components of a force, and resolved components are also called as rectangular or orthogonal components. Now see, here these are the two axes which are orthogonal, x-axis and y-axis, and force here is F, and to resolve it along X and Y we can write components as along X as Fx, and that is given by F cos theta, where theta is the angle of that force in the anticlockwise direction with respect to positive x-axis, and F2 component or Fy component along y-axis is given by F sin theta. So these are the resolved components on two mutually perpendicular axes. Resolution of a force into two non-perpendicular components, here say these are the two axes which are not perpendicular to each other, say this axis and this axis, they are not orthogonal or even perpendicular, and say here is the force which is making angle alpha with this axis and making angle beta with other axis. So to find components of F along this axis is given by F1, say, which is given by F sin beta divided by sin alpha plus beta, and component along this axis is given by F2, which is F sin alpha divided by sin alpha plus beta. Here F1 and F2 are called components of a force and not resolved components. Then later on we will see composition of forces, and that is nothing but the process of finding out a single force in place of given forces, and which we will see in detail later on. So now resolution, as we discussed, it is given or it is defined by this. Then this is how resolve components along x and y on orthogonal axis can be written. Here resolve components of force F along non-perpendicular axis are given like this. Now before solving problems for resolution, let us see how forces can be taken on or with respect to axis or along main directions. Suppose you are given a force acting due north, then it can be shown like, say we are showing two orthogonal axes, and if you show main directions, then north direction here, south here, on the right side east, and on the west side F. So as per this statement, force acting due north, then we have to show like this, that is force acting in the north direction. Now say second force along x-axis, then it can be shown like this. Here is say x-axis horizontal one and vertical axis y-axis, these two are orthogonal, and say force is along x-axis, then we can show like this, that is force F along x-axis. Now suppose you are given force acting from west, then again two directions, main directions north, south, east, west, which are again, we can know it, they are perpendicular to each other or they are orthogonal. So force acting from west can be shown like this, that is arrow from west towards origin. Now next, say force acting towards west, then it can be shown on this axis system from origin to the towards west. Then say force acting theta degree south of west, south of east, then it can be shown south of east means from east to the south, from east to the south. So it can be shown theta degree from east towards south. So it is a force acting theta degree south of east. Suppose we are asked to show force acting 30 degree south of east, then what to do? You have to take angle with respect to E, this direction 30 degree and clockwise. Okay, so it is called as 30 degree south of east. Now say force, you have to show force acting southwest, then again showing main directions north, south, east, west, and now we are asked to show southwest, then it means it is exactly in the middle of south and west. So we understand it is making angle 45 degree with west as well as 45 degree with south. So it can be shown like this. Now suppose we are given one problem, that is resolve force 10 newton incline 30 degree anticlockwise with positive x-axis. Then first of all you will have to show force according to this statement. So here are said two orthogonal axes, we can also call this as x-axis or even horizontal axis, this one as a vertical axis or y-axis, and as per our statement 10 newton force, so we have shown 10 newton, and it is making 30 degree angle, that is 30 degree here, anticlockwise means from with respect to positive x-axis, we have shown anticlockwise direction. 30 degree. Now to resolve force means to find out components of this force, which is also called as incline force. We can find component as 10 cos 30 along x, and 10 cos 30 will give us the value 8.66 newton. This is how we are getting effect of this force along x direction. So if 10 newton force is acting with this angle with respect to x, then its effect on x axis will not be 10 newton, but it will be 8.66 newton. So somewhat little than that value. And to find components along y direction, it is given by 10 sine 30, and 10 sine 30 is 5 newton. So here 10 newton force is resolved into two components along x and along y. So along x it is 8.66 and along y it is 5 newton. Now, suppose you are asked to resolve 800 kilonewton force acting southwest. Then, first of all, in the main direction system, you will have to show that 8 kilonewton force, 8 kilonewton, but where? Southwest means in the middle of this quadrant. So, we can show it is making angle with respect to west 45 degree, or even this angle will be also same with respect to south, because it is acting in the middle of west and south. So here 800 kilonewton force, which is making angle say with this line 45 degree, and to resolve this force along two mutually perpendicular axes, that is this axis and this axis, as per resolution rule, we will have component of this force 800 cos 45. Why we are writing cos 45 here? Because with respect to this angle, this component is the adjacent component. So whatever adjacent component is shown by cos. So here it is cos 800 cos 45. And that value on simplification 565.45 kilonewton. Now component of this force along this axis, now with respect to this angle, this component is called as opposite or even far component. This is adjacent component, so adjacent component we write as cos, while here opposite or far component always shown in terms of sine. So here it will be given by 800 sine 45, and simplifying this 565.68 kilonewton. So this is how for 800 kilonewton force, which is acting southwest, shown like this, and components of which are given along this axis as 800 cos 45 and along y 800 sin 45, and we can also write its value using calculator. Now one more problem, say resolve 100 kilonewton force acting from north east. That is, we know here is north south, here it is east west, and you are asked northeast means in this quadrant of north and east. Now it is shown acting from means from that direction to origin. So if you are asked to write from northeast, then also we can show like this. So here 100 kilonewton force, which is pin shown here making angle 45 degree because it is northeast, means in the middle of this quadrant. And component of this is and nature of this force, as you see in the previous examples, nature was outward from origin, say from origin towards a particular direction. Here it is coming from particular direction towards origin. So this nature is called as, because it is acting towards a point, so this nature is called as compressive. And in this case our components would be acting towards point like this and not outward direction. Okay, so 100 kilonewton force making 45 degree angle with say east west direction, and it is say compressive, then component would be also compressive nature. These two components here, this component along this axis is given by again 100 cos 45, because with respect to this angle it is the adjacent component or nearer components. So 100 cos 45 is simplified as 70.71 kN. Now finding it component of this force along north south direction, then it will be given by 100 sin 45. Sin because with respect to this angle it is far component or opposite component, so it is given as sin. And 100 sin 45 gives 70.71 kilonewton value. Now say one more problem, resolve forces shown in figure along x axis and y axis. So suppose you are already given the figure and not the statement of the force system. So force system is already given, and here you can see three forces: 10 newton which is making angle 60 degree with vertical axis, 20 newton which is making angle 30 degree with negative x axis, and 50 newton force making 40 degree angle with vertical. So if you are asked to simplify this figure or to write components of each force, then we can simplify or write components altogether like this. So, and doing this, we are not changing the effect of all these forces on O. So here we can say this force system is equivalent to this one. That's why we are making it equal. Now resolving separately each and every force. Suppose we want to resolve this force. It is making angle 60 degree with vertical. So with respect to this angle, component of this 10 newton force would be 10 cos 60, and it is shown like this. Component of this force along x with respect to this angle, its component is far or opposite, so it can be shown as 10 sin 60. So we resolve this 10 newton force along y 10 cos 60 and along x 10 sin 60. Now next, 20 newton force is to be resolved. Then you see 20 newton force is also tensile, so its component will be towards outward or tensile nature. Here it is making 30 degree angle with x axis, which is negative x axis. So components of this 20 newton force would be in this direction towards this and vertical direction like this. And respect to this angle, component along this axis would be cos, and along this it would be sin. So writing those components here, 20 cos 30, that is along x, and along y 20 sine 30. So this is how 20 Newton force is written by their components 20 cos 30 and sine 20 sine 30. Now resolving this 15 Newton force, that is third one, it is making angle 40 degree with vertical. So its vertical component would be cos and horizontal component would be sine. So here, and it is tensile nature. So here along this direction, that component would be 15 cos 40 and 15 sine 40. So this is how all these forces acting at a time can be shown like this. So we have shown all the components of three forces which are inclined altogether. These all components are shown here, and doing so, its effect of all these three forces on point O is not being changed. So it is equivalent system. Now, say you are given problem like this. Find the orthogonal components, or say simplifying, or say you are asked to simplify the figure of the following forces all acting away from the point. 1. 100 Newton acting at 30 degree west of south. Second one, 400 Newton acting due north. Third, 250 Newton acting northeast. And fourth, 150 Newton acting due west. So to show all these forces all together on the axis, you will have to prepare a force system like this. First of all, we will draw main directions like north and south, then perpendicular to this as east and west. Okay, these two axes are orthogonal or perpendicular to each other. Now showing this first force, 100 Newton acting at 30 degree west of south. West of south means you have to consider this quadrant, west and south. 100 Newton, and they are all acting, all these forces, four forces are acting away from the point. So say they are acting from this point outward. Okay, so 100 Newton force you will have to show like this, which is making 30 degree west of south, that is from south to west, like this. So it is 30 degree, and this force is 100 Newton. So first force is shown as per statement like this, that is its magnitude is 100 Newton, making angle 30 degree with south, which is also called as 30 degree west of south. Then showing this second force, 400 Newton acting due north, that is it is acting in the north direction, or towards, we can also say this as acting towards north. So due north or towards north is one and same. So that you have to show as 400 Newton. Okay, then third force, 250 Newton acting northeast. So northeast means middle of north and east. So angle of that force would be 45 with either axis. Okay, so showing that force, 250, and once again it is away from the point. So from this point outward, exactly it is making angle 45 degree, and that magnitude is 250 Newton. Then fourth force, that is 150 Newton acting due west, then you will have to show that force towards west or due west like this, and that magnitude is 150 newton. Okay, so clear. So we have shown all these four forces acting at a time, and which is acting that is, all these forces are acting away from point O. First force shown 100 newton making angle 30 degree with south, that is 30 degree west of south. Then 400 newton acting due north, that is in the direction of north or towards north. Then third force 250 newton making angle 45 because it is northeast, that is middle of north and east, that is 45 degree. And 150 newton acting due west or towards west. So this is how orthogonal forces can be shown on the orthogonal axis. And now to resolve these forces along two orthogonal axes, we can resolve, there is no need of resolving this force, 400 newton force, because it is acting totally in the north direction. So its resolve component along this direction would be zero, and along that direction will be full, that is 400 newton. Here also effect of or even component of this force along west would be 150 newton and along this direction would be zero. While here these two forces, 250 newton and 100 newton, are called as inclined forces, and it will have value of that force along two orthogonal axes. So here if you write components of 400 newton, then 400 newton component will have its effect full in y direction. So Fy component would be 400 newton, and along x what will be its effect or component is zero, because it is acting totally in the north direction. Component of this 250 newton along x is given by Fx, and that will be 250 cos 45 degree. And along y, component of that is given by Fy is equal to 250 sin 45 degree. Now component of this 150 newton force, which is called as Fx, or along this direction, we consider this as a horizontal axis, so we can also consider this as x, and this we consider as y. So Fx is full 150 newton, and Fy component, that component along y would be 0 newton. And for this force, component along x component would be 100 sin 30 degree. Okay. As we discussed earlier, resolution of force into two non-perpendicular axes. Then suppose a problem related to that is given like this. What are the components of 60 newton force acting horizontal in two directions on either side at an angle of 30 degree with each? Then we can draw figure as per this statement, like 60 newton force like this, 60 newton. Two axes, say this and this. So component of this 60 newton along these two non-orthogonal axes would be given by, say this, along this as F1, and along this is say F2. Then this component, and say angle given as this angle as say alpha 30 degree, and with this is also say angle 30 degree, which we call as beta. So here, what are the components of 60 Newton force? That is this force acting horizontal, which is acting horizontal, that is say this axis is horizontal in two directions on either side at an angle 30 degree each. That is say we want to find out components of this force along to non-orthogonal axis, this and this, which is making angle 30 degree with 30 degree each with this horizontal axis. F1 component along this axis is given by 60, as per our formula, it is given by F sine beta divided by sine alpha plus beta. So writing that formula first, F sine beta divided by sine alpha plus beta. Writing values here, F is 60, so 60 sine beta, that is this angle 30 degree, divided by sine alpha, that is this angle, plus beta, which is also 30 degree. And on simplifying this, we will get value 34.64 Newton. Then F2 is given by same formula, but change in angles sine alpha divided by sine alpha plus beta. So 60 sine 30 divided by sine 30 plus 30. Simplifying this, we will get 34.64 Newton, because this is having symmetry about this axis, so two components would be equal here. But say these angles are different, then we will get components along these two directions different. Now we would discuss about graphical method, because it will be needed in many cases for solving for problems related to concurrent forces. So here, first of all, we will understand what is graphical method. So here, graphical method is nothing but this method incorporates use of geometrical figures, elliptical points, geometrical figures like points, straight lines, non-shapes, etc. So actually graphical method is nothing but it is a way of representing the given case for finding whatever required by means of a figure and not by formulas. Clue points here, the results obtained by this method may tally with that obtained by analytical, which is involved numerical equations or formulas, if enough care is being taken. This is important. In graphical method, you need very much care. That is, so say enough care is not taken, then it would give results which are not matching with analytical, or which will not give the accurate results. It is used. Then why we are using this method? Because it is used if the force system is complicated, or even say we want to find out results which required not that much accuracy. Now here are certain terms which are associated with graphical method. So we need to understand these basic terms related with graphical solution. First of all, force system. We know, I discussed earlier, that force system is nothing but when two or more forces act on a body or point, they are called or said to form a system of force or force system. So this is what is shown as force system. Say here is two strings are tied here and weight is hanged here by means of these two strings, then this system is known as force system. Stress diagram. If forces acting in a system are represented by direction in the form of diagram using Bowes notations, the diagram is known as space diagram. As we discussed earlier, Bowes notations are nothing but method of naming force. Suppose this is one force, it can be named as force FAB. What we are doing in Bowes notations, we are giving capital letters or alphabets on either side of force. So say we have given Bowes notations for this force as on this side this space is given letter A, this space is given letter B. For say second force on this side or on this space, letter is already B we have given, and on the side we would have to give second letter, so that is say C. Now if we consider this force, then it will have on this side or on this space letter C already given, and on this side letter A already given. So this is how forces from this force system shown like this by giving Bowes notations, then whatever diagram we are getting is known as space diagram. So this is what required in graphical method. One other terms which are useful in drawing or adopting graphical method, vector diagram. So it is nothing but a diagram showing each force or even reactions of space diagram in magnitude and direction is called vector diagram. So if from the space diagram we show forces to the scale, then in magnitude and direction, then that diagram is known as vector diagram. Our usual practice is to give space diagram capital letters, while here drawing this vector diagram is to give small letters in place of capital letters. So vector diagram is like that. Free body diagram means for a given body, if supports are removed and forces acting on the body and supports or reactions are shown, the diagram so obtained is known as free body diagram. So what we are doing, as we see in the force system previously, say this is the system given. Out of this system, we could see here on this point, these are the forces acting on the point. So if we detach this point along with forces acting on it, then that diagram is shown like this. Here we can show it like this. So this is nothing but free body diagram, which is freed from that original force system. We are not showing here even walls or ceiling. What we are showing here, we are showing a point and forces acting on that point. So this type of diagram is known as free body diagram. So now we are well conversant of graphical method, that is which terms are associated with it, and say we want to find out solution using graphical method, then what we'll do. Suppose we are given, we want to say resolve a force which is inclined one by means of graphical method. Suppose you are given a case of say 5 Newton force, that is F, making angle 30 degree with positive x-axis in the anticlockwise direction. Then to find out component of this force F along x, say this is x direction, this is y direction, mostly we involved or even you involved to find out components, or even you would be involved to find components along two orthogonal axes, and in rare cases you will be involved in finding components along non-orthogonal axis. So it is important how to find components along two mutually perpendicular axes, that we discussed already in detail. So as per analytical method, we understand component of this 5 Newton force would be along this direction, say it is Fx, then it is given by F cos theta, cos because respect to this angle, its component along this direction is nearer or adjacent, so it is cos. So as per this, we will have 5 cos 30, and this value would come 4.3. Okay, and along y, that value is given by, that is component of this force along y, we know it is given by F sine theta, that is putting values 5 sine 30 degree, and that gives you the value 2.5 newton. So here component of 5 newton force along x is 4.3 newton and along y it is 2.5 newton. This is how we are getting analytically. Now we want, suppose we want to find out the component of this 5 newton force along x and y by graphical means, then what we will have to do, as per description I given, you will have to draw a space diagram first. That is, you will have to draw this 5 Newton force, that arrow making angle 30 degree, and this you will have to draw exactly measuring with the help of protractor. So first of all, you need to draw this system showing exact 30 degree angle, and that is known as space diagram. So we would name that diagram as space diagram. Then, and in every graphical method, we need some scale. So here, say we are taking scale for drawing vector diagram. Why we are drawing vector diagram? To get resolved component of this 5 Newton force. So in vector diagram, we would draw 5 Newton force to the scale that is showing its magnitude and direction. So you will have to draw a line parallel to this 5 Newton force like this, and as per scale. Say we take a scale 1 Newton is equal to 1 centimeter, then you would have to draw this line 5 centimeter long and parallel to that this line, because we have to draw that in the same direction. Now resolve component of this force is given by drawing from this point line parallel to this x-axis, because we want to get component along x. So if you draw line parallel to x-axis here, then it will go in this direction. Then from this point, that is for this force, this point is known as start or tail, and while this point is on a, known as tail, head. This has a start point, that is tail, and end point as head. So from head of the force, you draw a line which is parallel to y-axis, And wherever these two lines drawn from tail and head intersect, then say they are intersecting here, and this is nothing but x component of this force, and this gives you value of y component of this force. Of course, these values would be in the terms of centimeter, because we have taken scale for drawing these lines. What we have to do, finally getting values in terms of Newton, you will have to use scale taken. So drawing this as per scale, we'll get component along x as 4.3 centimeter, and our scale is at par, that is 1:1, so that force is known as 4.3 Newton. And this component, we'll get this length 2.5 centimeter. So what will be that force or that component? Fy component would be 2.5 Newton. So this is how in graphical method we are finding components of the inclined force. So in this method we are drawing space diagrams, and also we are drawing vector diagrams. Now composition of force. So we, as we discussed earlier, the process of finding out a single force in place of number of forces is called composition of force. Suppose here are the two components Fx and Fy, and say we want to find out a single force in place of these two components, then it is nothing but its original value of force. So here whatever effect of these two components we are getting as a single force is shown as F here, so that is known as composition. So composition is what? The process of finding out a single force in place of number of forces is called composition. So here in place of Fx and Fy we are getting one force F here, so it is known as composition. So it is shown in magnitude and direction both. So this is what composition is. Now suppose in case you are given number of forces along say x as fx1 and fx2, along y as fy1 and fy2, then finding effect of all say these four forces, we want to show it by a single force, then it can be shown as single force like F here. So it would be F here giving effect of all these Fx1, Fx2, Fy1, Fy2 as a single force F, and its direction is say theta. So this is what the composition of the forces. So this is up for resolution and composition. Thank you.